Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm gonna be walking you guys through my skincare routine. These are a few images of what my skin used to look like in high school and my early college days, just to show you how much my skin has improved since then, now that I have a skincare routine that works for me. Now, the first thing I do is wash my hands. I like to start off my routine with fresh, clean hands since I'm going to be touching my face. So no matter what, I don't start skincare without washing my hands. Once I finish washing my hands, I proceed to wet my face to prep for my cleanser. I use Cetaphil Daily Facial Cleanser for normal to oily skin as well as a facial brush with a silicone head. I like to go in and spread the cleanser on my face first, then I'll turn on my brush to actually begin scrubbing. Personally, my skin is combination. I get oily in my T-zone area, but around my mouth and the bottom of my cheeks near my jawline, I tend to get really dry. Additionally, my skin can be sensitive, so I use a silicone brush because it's more gentle than a bristle brush, and then I also feel like I'm getting a deeper clean than just using my hands. I have seen on TikTok that apparently Cetaphil isn't a good facial cleanser, but in my experience, I was recommended to use this cleanser by my dermatologist years ago, and so far I haven't had any negative experiences with it, but I do think eventually I will try a CeraVe cleanser to see what the fuss is about. Anyways, I like to scrub my skin for 120 seconds, and yes, I do sit there and count every time. I think you only need to scrub for at least 60 seconds, but I like to do it a tad bit longer. Once I'm done, I wash the cleanser off my face, and I know this sounds weird, but I like to pat the excess water off my skin with a paper towel. It just feels more gentle to my skin, in my opinion. Once my face is just damp, I go in with my Good Molecules toner, and let me just say, I love this toner. I just started using this toner recently, and I've noticed that my pores look smaller, and my skin tone has evened out quite a bit. You can apply with your hands, but I like to pour it on a cotton pad and then spread it on my face. The next thing I do is go in with the Ordinary Alpha Arbutin Serum. I recently started using this serum as well, and I love it. I honestly love all the skincare products I'm using right now. Anyways, I put a couple of drops on my face, then I spread it around and pat the product into my skin. Before this, I didn't use the serum, but since my skin has cleared up quite a bit, my main focus has been to brighten and even up my skin, and this serum has done wonders, and my skin has brightened up since I started using this product. Now we're going to do a quick switch to my night skincare routine. There are only a couple of differences, but this is one of them. At night is when I prefer to do face masks, so after doing toner, I like to apply a face mask if I'm doing one. The first face mask I'm showing is the Ordinary Peeling Solution that I recently bought. I'm not applying that because I've already applied it for the week, but I am doing my go-to face mask that I got from Amazon. It is a sheet mask that focuses on hydrating and brightening the skin. When I use face masks, I do prefer using ones that focus on hydrating the skin. After applying this mask, I leave it on my face for 40 minutes. After the 40 minutes are up, I come back with the mask barely attached to my face. I'll take it off and use the sheet to put any excess product on my skin. Then I'll use my hands to pat the product into my skin. After I'm done with the face mask, I'll then follow up with the Good Molecules Discoloration Serum. I just started using this product, and since my skin can be sensitive, I'm scared to put two serums on at the same time. But once my skin gets adjusted, I'll start using them together. But I'll do the same process as the last serum and spread it over my face before patting it into my skin. Now back to the morning routine, but the same process. After serum, I'll apply the CeraVe Daily Moisturizing Lotion to my face, and I lather this product onto my skin. I'm very generous with the amount and rub it all over my face and down my neck. After moisturizer in the morning, I will lastly apply some SPF 50. I put a good amount of SPF on as well. This product does leave a slight white cast to your skin, so I'm trying to find a product that doesn't. But in my experience, the white cast doesn't bother me because it seems to go away after some time, or I'm putting on makeup so it's not noticeable. Back to my night routine, because this is another difference. At night, after applying moisturizer, I'll apply face oil instead of SPF. I do prefer rosehip oil, but I don't think that matters much. I put three drops on my face and then rub it into my face and neck. And using face oil has improved my dry skin, which is something I typically experience in the morning. Finally, the last thing I do morning and night is moisturize my lips with petroleum jelly. My jar has definitely seen better days, but this is a nice, affordable way to moisturize my lips with a product that actually lasts quite a while. So that is it for my skincare routine. I hope you guys enjoyed watching. If you have made it this far into the video, please go ahead and subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to like and comment, and I'll see you guys next time.